Hello people, welcome back to my channel. The topic for today's video is delta rule. So in the last video we saw what was back propagation algorithm, and we saw some derivatives and derivations which we come across the loss functions, and we saw how we represented in matrix form. So in today's video, let's see what is delta rule and where it is mainly used. So delta rule is mainly used for your perceptron learning. So in the very first video regarding the deep learning, we have seen that we have two kinds of neurons or two kinds of neural network structure. One that is MCP, and we regarded it because it does not represent the XOR implementation or the XOR gate. And then we have the perceptron. So that is the Rosenblatt perceptron that we majorly use. So delta rule is mainly used for updation of the weights. So essentially this delta rule comes from, or it is derived from, your gradient descent. So gradient descent we already know that is from our linear regression. So I'll just put the link in the description, you'll check that video. And so what we basically do is say we have our network, say x4, and then we have say some neurons at this particular point. Then we have some connections which is connecting to these neurons, and what we have is we have the final output, that is y cap. So you know that there are some weights present at this particular point. So you have a weight matrix of 3 × 4, and then at the second layer you have a weight matrix of 2 × 3, and then at the third layer you have a weight matrix of 1 × 2. So our major goal is to learn these weights. So that is the major goal, that is when we implement the neural networks or whenever we do deep learning. So I have mentioned before that these weights are assigned randomly. So but we have not discussed why these are assigned randomly or why we are not keeping a uniform value across all these. So today we'll be starting with this issue, that is why we assign this randomly. So whenever we design any neural network, it always has a problem called as symmetry breaking, or also called as problem of symmetry. So say for example, we are initially assigning these weights as say 10, 10, 10 for all these weights, that is for 12 weights across these connections in the first layer, we are keeping it as 10, means we are keeping one single value. Now this particular weights will update depending upon the error value that you get at the final output. So essentially when you just back propagate across the different layers, each of them have to be updated equally. Why? Because they have all identical weights. Now say for example, these are some marks of some particular student. Now if the teacher just graded them equally, means they do not differentiate between each other, means if one person has got 10 out of 20 and if I'm also getting the same, then I would not go to a teacher and just complain why I got 10 and why he did not got some other mark. So that differentiation or that will not happen in this particular case. So what essentially we'll do is this will learn nothing. So if you are initially assigning all the weights as equal, what eventually the neural network will do is it will learn nothing at all. But if you assign this as some randomly, so say this has got 15, this has got 20, this has got 11, then there becomes a picture of like why this particular weight is assigned 15, or why this has assigned 20, or why this has 11. So this particular problem is mainly counteracted with the help of randomly assigning. So if you want just geometrically to represent, say we have two weights and say we have two coordinates, somewhere here. So what we can see is it will form the error pattern in this way. So you can see there is a saddle shaped function that is formed across this error pattern. So the error in one particular layer is mitigated with the help of adjusting the weights, which are put randomly. So that is the main reason why we assign the weights randomly. So if in this particular scenario, say this is the positive quadrant and this is the negative quadrant, so whatever portion you can see here, so there you have to adjust the weights accordingly. So if it at the beginning you assign the weights as equal, say 0 0, then eventually they would not be learning anything. So that's why we mainly use the random weights. So we assign random weights whenever we start the neural network learning. So our major goal in Delta rule is to learn this weights, so that weight updation whenever we get the final output, that is changed with the help of some rule. So we know that our error function, that is J, that is dependent on the weights and the biases. So that is given as, say we are taking D, that is for each instance we are calculating TD minus OD, TD minus OD square. So this is not new, so you are familiar with this, that is Y and Y cap the same, that is we saw from linear regression for gradient descent. So we are just changing the terminology here. So TD is nothing but our training value and OD is our output function or output value. Say initially for the setting we have given the output as W0. Now this is for the bias. Then we have W1 X1 plus W1 X1 square plus W2 X2 plus W2 X2 square and so on up till WN XN plus WN XN square. So what we need to do is we need to differentiate this error function. So error somewhere is also represented as E, so we'll just go with only one notation, that is we'll stick to J, that is for Jacobian, we'll not change this each and every time. So what we need to do is we need to differentiate this J with respect to each and individual weights. So if you just represent this, so that is with respect to W0, with respect to W1, with respect to W2 and so on up till say with respect to WN and dou J with respect to WN plus 1. So we majorly update the weights across different layers so that we get a uniform error that is obtained at the final output. So how we do this? So for doing this we need to take the differentiative of this. So just remember our output is represented in this form. So it is some linear and then it has some polynomial. It's not completely linear, but it is linear in weights. It's not linear in your input vector. So what I basically do is I take the derivative of this. So I need to differentiate this particular equation. So, and one major thing why we have taken square, because it is a convex function and so we can easily differentiate it. So that's why we have taken the 2 and we have averaged it over 2. Normally we use 1 by n, so here n is kept as 2. So if we want to differentiate this particular thing, how would we go is say dou j by dou wi. So we have 1 by 2, so that is a constant. If we want to differentiate this, that is d belongs to d. That is 2 times of TD minus OD and then you again have this part TD minus OD. So this is clear. So we have differentiated this just as it is. Now what we do is if you just closely inspect, these terms gets cancelled out. So we can just take this part on the other side. So our differentiative, so I can represent it as we are differentiating with respect to our weight vector. So everything is a vector representation. So whether it is our weights or whether it's our input, everything is weight vector. So what we have is we'll just keep this side. We have this summation d, which belongs to this capital D, represents your entire population of your data, and out of that you are taking one particular instance. And then you want to differentiate this particular with respect to wi td minus od. So say now you have d belongs to d, td minus od, and what I do is I'll just represent this od in some form. So we know that our od was represented in as w0 plus w1 x1 plus w1 x1 square. So I'll write a generalized formation of this particular representation. So what I do is I'll just write it as w vector. So that is a weight vector. That is a general for all the weights. So regardless it's w0, w1, w2, wn, I'll represent it as w vector. And we have some input vector. So that is for each instance. D represents each instance. And plus we have, that is in the similar form, but here we have one square term. And we'll just close the bracket. So what I did is I just represented my output function with respect to whatever is given. Now what we do is we need to take the differentiative. So TD minus OD, what we have is this part remains constant, so that is zero. So whatever we have in this particular form, so that is if you just open the brackets, you have minus, so that is x bar. Now, just remember this I is with respect to this input vector. So what we can just do is we can just put a counter of I over d. So that is weight differentiative of this weight with respect to this function. So that is nothing but minus xd bar. And similarly, you have xd id bar square. So that is simple. So what we can obtain is we can take one negative sign outside id, and we can write in this way. So if I just take the minus over this, that is td minus od, and we have multiplied with id plus x bar square id. So now this particular entire function is what you just differentiated. So that becomes your error function. So let us call this as some delta j or del j with respect to some weight vector. So since you have differentiated with respect to weight, you have some this notation. So now whenever you do gradient descent, you know that is you have a learning rate or a learning parameter, that is eta. So let us say we have taken a small baby step of 0.05 error learning rate. So now what we can do is we can essentially represent this as negative. So that is going down the valley by taking small baby steps. That's why you have a negative sign. And then you have this learning rate, eta, and then del j with the weight vector. So this was our delta w weight vector, or in fact, if you want to represent in some other notation, say with respect to wi, how you can represent is minus eta, and you have dou j by dou wi. So you can represent in either of the way for delta rule for learning perceptron. So well, that was all regarding the delta rule for perceptron learning in deep learning. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you got educated about this video, please do like, share, comment, and if you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching this video.